In a former video, I've shown how to do a Fourier series, Fourier decomposition, or Fourier analysis of a periodic signal using the FFT function in MATLAB. So I will once again open up the program that was developed there in this video and run it. And then we can see that different plots should appear if the MATLAB program is finished. So first thing that we should look at again is the time function. We can see, so about 2 seconds is the period of time. So the lowest frequency that we should get in the spectrum should be around 0.5 Hertz. And we can see that there is a, let's say, a slower oscillation with around this frequency of 0.5 or maybe 1 Hertz. And then there is a more rapid oscillation on top of this. And then using the program, here we would calculate the spectrum and plot the spectrum. So this was the amplitude spectrum and this was the phase spectrum. And there are some main components here at around 0.51 Hertz and one component at 5 Hertz. And so now the idea of this video is to show how to reconstruct the time function, how to reconstruct this time signal here as a sum of cosine functions with a certain frequency, with a certain amplitude, and with a certain phase shift. So first thing that I will do is again take a look at the spectrum. The spectrum was this one here. So take the magnitude spectrum and sort this, because I want to have most important components within the spectrum. So I will sort the spectrum. I will maybe enlarge this one here a little bit and say this should be saved in a vector, in an array that is called sorted. So now we can have a look at this and see that it's sorted in a way. If I take a look at the first 10 components, that it's starting with the smallest ones, but I want to have the largest ones first. So I will inverse the order of this one and say from the end, going down by minus one to the beginning, I want to inverse the order. And now if I plot the first 10 components again, now I have the strongest components here. Okay, so let's copy this back into the script. And then I will continue, I think, programming in the script, because then I can run it and rerun it again. So this inverses the order, and this was sorting of the magnitude spectrum. So now I want to reconstruct a signal using, let's say, the 2 or 3 or 4 or whatever 5 most important components. So I will say let's do it for 3. And then we should have a loop over each of these components. So this small n component will count from 1 to this number here. And inside this loop, at first I will get the amplitude, the current amplitude of this component will be the nth entry within this vector. So then I already get the amplitude, but we also need the frequency and we need the corresponding phase for this component, for this harmonic. So how to get the frequency? So first thing that we can do is we can from our real spectrum here, this is the unsorted one, we can get the index of the frequency, and therefore we can search in this vector and find the entry where we have the current amplitude, the maximum amplitude, which must not necessarily be the first one, of course. And we just want to find one of these entries, and hopefully the first one. this approach only works if really the amplitudes are all different. If you have a strange time function where there are some frequency components where the where some amplitudes are the same, then this might cause some problems. But this is the frequency index, and from the frequency index we can get the current frequency from our vector of frequencies. This one was given here, and so at this index. And we can also get the phase, and the phase, this was here the angle. So I will call it phase angle. We get from this the angle of the complex component, and then also at this entry where we have the certain frequency. Okay, so we have amplitude, we have frequency, we have angle. We maybe need to have the angular frequency. So we take the frequency and multiply it with 2 times p, and then we get the angular frequency. And that's more or less it. So now we want to calculate f from x, our time function, but as a reconstruction. So this will be the reconstructed signal. And so we take what we already have. We need to set this to 0 first. I will do this in a second. And then we add the current component. And the current component is the amplitude times a cosine function that depends on omega times t. T is the time from t is the time that we get from our initial simulated data, plus this certain phase shift. And the phase angle, the phase shift we get from here. So that's it. And now this must be set to 0 at the beginning. So I will set this to zeros in the size of the vector t. So however large t is, then this one will be filled with zeros as a vector. So we have it here and we can add our current component. And so then we can plot it and check if it works. So I will just copy this one here. And plot it into figure 4, and now we want to have the time and the original function and the reconstructed function. And maybe add a legend which says the first entry is the original function and the second entry is the reconstruction. Okay. Then let's check it out. Oh, and there's some error as usual in this line here. Okay, of course, just this closing bracket is missing. Okay, and there, as we can see, it works very nice. So from the three most important harmonics, and we should display them, but it should be this one with an amplitude of around 140, and then this one, and then the next one should be this. And we can see it works quite good. It works very well. If I go back to just one component, so we just take the most important harmonic. Yeah, so then we can see, of course, it doesn't work. Yeah, we cannot replicate this quite complicated signal, but just by just one cosine wave. But it fits more or less. If we take two components, then it should get better. And if we take three, we have already seen, I think looking at the amplitude spectrum, if we take four, so the fourth one, this is also quite important, and the other ones, they are quite small in comparison with this. So if we take four components, this should look very, very well. So as we can see, we can reconstruct this quite complicated time signal by a sum of for cosine waves with certain amplitudes, multiples of fundamental frequency stored in this omega and with a certain phase angle. And that's more or less it. What might be interesting is to display the values. So this is what I will add here. Output the components. So what we maybe want to display is the, let's say, the index or the number of the component. Then we maybe want to output the frequency. We want to output the amplitude and we want to output the phase. I have to move my camera window. The phase, and I need to add some units. So this is the phase in degree. The amplitude here in this example is in Newton and the frequency is in Hertz. Okay, so this will output like the table header to the command line. And so then we need to output and convert the number to a string of this component. So this is like the first, the second, and so on. Then I need some white space and I will then just copy this. So the first, the second thing that we want to output is the frequency. The frequency is stored here in this variable. Next one that we want to have is the amplitude. The amplitude is stored in this variable here. And the last thing that we want to output is, move my camera window again. The last thing that we want to output is the phase. And the phase angle is stored here in phase angle. And I don't need to have this space here at the end because I think then the line is over. And yeah, I don't know if the white space is enough, but it should do for the beginning. So there is the reconstructed signal. We can see now we have these four components at these frequencies. With these amplitudes and with these phase shifts. And these phase shifts, as we can see, they are not in degree yet, and we need some more white space. So I will just shortly add some white space here, and then the phase angle, this is in radians. If we want to have it in degree, we need to multiply with 180 and divide by p. And if we have something in degree, it's sufficient if we have just four digits, four numbers to show this. So some more white space would be needed, but this is a quite nice table where we can see what are the, whatever, two or three, or in this case, four most important components, harmonics inside the signal, at which frequency they are, which amplitude do they have, and which phase shift of a cosine function. And that's it. This shows how to replicate a signal from the Fourier decomposition, from the Fourier analysis, from its harmonics in MATLAB.